people will tell you that to get the results you want in life, you have to go harder. Not getting results in the gym? Do double the workouts. Not losing weight? Eat half the food. You're not getting good school grades or performing well at work? Go harder. Everything we hear about our messages in the West is about going harder and doing more. Now in this video, I want to share another alternative that can often get you the same results or even better. And that is why going sage mode is better sometimes than going beast mode. Hey guys, Alex Hine here, author of the book Master of the Day. Now the very first reason is that sage mode is about thinking consciously about what you want and if your efforts are getting you what you want. I mean, think about how many people wake up in the morning, they hate their lives, just like I used to. You wake up for a job you hate, for a routine you hate, an evening that you hate, that's boring. And you just think, I have to push. I just have to get through this day. You just gotta do what you gotta do. This is being an adult, Jimmy. You just do the work. You show up to your job, you work hard, and then you come home, you get your pay, and you have dinner, drink a beer, and watch Netflix. That's just life. You know, as a kid, I heard that every day, and all I could think was, well, I want a refund on life because that is not the life I want. And so as a result, I didn't model a lot of the people that I saw around me, and certainly not the ones that just told me, that's just how life is. Those are the first people I ignored. Now the thing is, anybody can push. Anybody can push, do more, work harder, add extra hours, always about more. But the thing I struggled with that has made a big difference in my life is in doing less. And very often, if you do the opposite, you decide to do less, make it easier, make it more simple. When you ask yourself the question, if I could do less or make it easier and get the same or better results, what would I do? And the funny thing is, you will always find something that's easier, that's less hard, that feels better internally, and it gets you the same or even better results. So sage mode is about consciously thinking, how do I want to feel and what are the fruits of my efforts that I want? But which one would be better? Feeling good and producing good fruit versus feeling like crap and producing good fruit? Why not have both? The second reason you should go sage mode over beast mode is that there is a limit to how much you can push. And I personally learned that limit very quickly last year, doing 70 or 80 hour weeks, started having heart palpitations every day, severe insomnia, and about 15 other symptoms from burnout. Now, the problem is, for me, I've always been a I'll also do that too kind of person. Doing med school, running a business, want to write another book? Yeah, why not? Let's do it. That sounds fun. So I did it. I wrote my second full-length book, coming right into my first half of the year of medical schooling. Managed to fry myself, but hey, I did it, right? I'm still alive. Not in the hospital. Nothing worked out poorly. The solution for sage mode versus beast mode is instead to ask yourself, how could I get more life? Sage mode is about how to get more life out of your hours. Anyone can add more, right? Anyone can push harder, but that's cheating yourself out of life, like I said. And so the question is, could you get the same results by doing less? Could you get the same results by doing half the work or smarter work or being more efficient or taking less breaks? If you took every aspect of your life, especially the things that required the most time, and you could make them as simple as they could be, what if you could do it the most simple as possible and get the same results? What if you thought how to be smarter about reaching your goals, whether it's in the gym or financially or in relationship, versus always thinking about more as the first option? Now, the third thing is that beast mode versus sage mode doesn't take into account how you feel. And that, look, that's the point. The reason why beast mode doing more works is because if you ignore how you feel, then you can do anything, right? You work 16 hours a day, no problem. You want to run 8 ultra marathons back to back? No problem. You can do that. But if you feel like crap internally, there is always a price to pay. And this is not me saying you shouldn't push or go hard or go beast mode sometimes. But when you choose to go beast mode all the time, it's like Johnny from The Shining, right? All work and no play makes Johnny a dull boy. And that was definitely how I become when I work too much. I get more serious. I'm less happy. It's harder for me to laugh. I'm more head down all the time. My posture changes. Everything about you changes when you're one of the hard people whose solution to everything is go harder. It's very obvious at first glance when you see one of these people and the vibe that they give off. And it works, you know, but it doesn't always work. Because what happens if you're the artist or the writer or the veterinarian or the person that wants to open a dog park and you become the lawyer? You ignore your insides. You're like, ah, that's stupid. My mom, my dad told me that's stupid. I need to pay my rent. So you become the lawyer. You pass the bar and do all the hard things 20 years later, only to end up as that alcoholic because you inside, you knew what you wanted and you ignored it and you stuffed it down. And there's a time and a place for that, but what if you could have the same success and feel awesome about it? There's a big difference in the way those people feel. So this third virtue, the part of Sage Mode, is having that inner calm of feeling good first internally and then externally having the results and the fruit that you want. So I hope that helps you guys. Before you go, I want you to comment there below. What is one of the problems you're working on tackling in your life that you could apply more Sage Mode versus Beast Mode to? Because this is something I'm working on. Hey guys, well, one of the things that goes along with being in Sage Mode, like I talk about here, is being calm and being sage. Now, the biomat is a pad you can put on your bed or on the floor, which uses technology that was actually discovered by NASA to help you reduce stress and fatigue. Now, it produces negative ions, which are considered nature's energizer. And these negative ions you can find in abundance in places like forests and mountains, waterfalls and oceans. Now, the biomat in particular is comprised of three parts that helps you have that stress relief and that fatigue relief. Now, the biomat can also help with pain relief and circulation. It is FDA cleared, and one of the cool things is that it profoundly affects both the nervous system while also promoting deep relaxation. So it kind of has this dual energizing and relaxing effect. Also, the people at the biomat store recommend and encourage you to call for personalized customer service and advice. It's kind of unique among companies now that basically don't want to deal with you, so that is worth investigating as well. And like some customers have said, it's really restorative. So a direct quote from one person was that it's the world's greatest power nap. Check out the biomat link here on the screen or in the description box there below if you'd like to find out more information on it.